Okay, this is chapter 4, and the main topic in chapter 4 is binomial distribution, but in section 4.1 we deal with random variables. Well, a random variable, this is getting you ready for section 4.2, but a random variable could either be discrete random variable or a continuous random variable, and a discrete random variable cannot be a fraction. That's the type that we're dealing with here in chapter 4. Like, if you flip a coin 10 times, how many times does it land heads? Well, it could land heads none of those 10 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way up through 10 of those times heads, but it can't land heads 1.5 times. Now, a continuous random variable can be a fraction, and that's where we get into other topics that are in chapter 6, 7, and 8, and so on. So let's first of all identify a variable as whether it's discrete or continuous. Well, like we said, you flip a coin, what's the probability that it lands heads? Well, there's only two choices. It either lands heads or it doesn't. And it lands heads at a integer amount of time, not a fraction of a time. So this is a discrete random variable. You take a test, how long does it take? Well, it could take 60 minutes, it could take 62 minutes, it could take 62.3 minutes, and so on. So this could be a fractional answer, so this is not continuous. You plant a tree, does it live? Well, it either lives or it dies. It's either like a yes or a no question. It's not a half-dead type of thing, so this would be a discrete random variable. You roll a die, what number does it land, or what number does it show would be probably a better way to say that. Well, it either shows a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. It doesn't show a 1.5, so this would be a discrete random variable. You roll a die, does it land odd or even? It either lands odd or it lands even. There's no fractional answer to that, so it's discrete. You roll a die, does it land 6? It either does or it doesn't, so it's again, discrete random variable. These are also discrete random variables. You draw a card from a deck of 52 cards, a person guesses the cards, the card is then replaced, and the person guesses again. You either guess it right or you guess it wrong. Same way with this one, you either guess it right or you guess it wrong. It's not that you guess it half right. If we had a variable like a person's weight or something like that, that is a continuous random variable because your weight could be 132 pounds, it could be 180, it could be 180.7 pounds, whatever. So it could be fractional, so it would be continuous. But the type that we're dealing with in this chapter is discrete random variable. Well, for a discrete random variable, the expected value, or the mean, which is another name for the average, can be calculated by summing the product of each probability with its value. So for example, if we had a table of values, and we have a discrete situation here with a person's age, and now I know somebody could be 18.5 or 19.2 years old or so on, but we're breaking up into discrete sections here. A person is either 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. We're breaking it into these integer values, no fractions allowed. So we do have a discrete random variable here, a person's age rounded to the nearest year. That's a discrete random variable. And we have the probability that a person is of each of these ages. Then with these, what we do is we multiply the age times the probability that a person is that age, and then we add this up. For example, we take 18 times 0.2, 19 times 0.3, 20 times 0.2, and so on, and then add up all those. And so to get the expected value, or the average age, we would do exactly like I said here, 18 times 0.2, 19 times 0.3, and so on, and add those up, and we get 20.2. Well, this is a discrete random variable that is not binomial. We haven't gone over binomial distributions yet. We'll do that in the next video. But to answer questions like this, we can do it on the Excel sheet under the binomial sheet, and then just scroll to the right. So if we scroll to the right, it has a place where you can put in discrete non-binomial distributions. We put it in our ages right here, 18 through 25, and we put it in our probabilities right here. And down below, it shows us our expected value, or average, to be 20.2, which you could also calculate by hand. It also tells us our variance and our standard deviation is automatically calculated for us when we put these values in. So that will do it, really, with section 4.1. Section 4.1 is just identifying whether a variable is discrete or continuous, and for finding probabilities, you can just use this area of the binomial sheet.